are just as excited as I am because today is a STEM Wednesday. We're going to be learning about science, and I guess since today's Wednesday, it would be wacky weather. Weather Wednesday. Yeah, we're doing that. I'm super excited. I love a good science experiment, and I love science experiments that are going to be super messy because it just makes it that much more fun. So if you are here and you are watching, you're definitely going to want to go into the comments, let us know you're here so we can talk directly to you. Or if you don't want to, don't have to. No pressure. We are going to be doing an experiment involving shaving cream, so you want some of that on hand. You need some water. You need a clear glass. Mine is, or clear plastic, just something clear. Mine is a clear cylinder. You would like some food coloring, and then if you have your own like droppers, or you can use a spoon, or you can use a straw, whatever you have around, here in your house. Yeah, do whatever you want. And then I have cups of water over here. You can't see them though, because it's a surprise, because science. So, just to recap, we are going to be talking about the weather today. Super exciting. It's actually been really interesting weather-wise today because it was very like cold and like cloudy this morning, and now it's nice and warm, and I'm very upset about that because I was excited to wear a sweater and now I don't get to wear one. So, you know, no fun for anybody. As always, I have Miss Elisa working the camera. She's amazing. She'll be asking. She's just a hand. But she's there. She's like a That's that creature from the Addams Family who's just a hand.
Uncle Hand? I don't know.
Uncle Hand. If you know, please tell us in the comments because I don't remember. But it's the creature from the Addams Family that runs and he's just like just a hand. But anyway, back to what we're talking about. We are going to be learning about weather. And also we have our other STEM session that runs on Fridays at 2:30, and that's with Miss Elisa. It's aimed towards our older kids. But you're more than welcome to show up if you just want to learn new things. So, we're going to go ahead and get started. If you didn't already know, I'm Miss Tammy, and Miss Lisa working the camera. Okay, so, as always, we're going to go over how to be a good scientist. So right over here, we have our little snake. His name is Einstein, because Einstein is a very famous scientist. You see what I did there? Okay, so how to be a good scientist. A good scientist asks questions. So at any time, feel free to ask us a question. If we know the answer, we will give you the answer. If we don't know the answer, we will find it out together. Next, a good scientist observes. So you want to make sure you're paying attention and following along, and feel free to like talk to your moms or your dads and ask them questions. You know, don't be shy. Next, a good scientist does experiments, which we'll always do. I love experiments. It's the cornerstone of great science is experiments. So, we do experiments. A good scientist makes good guesses. There is no wrong guess. A guess is a guess. You just take a chance, make a guess, and then if it's right, it's right. If it's wrong, it's wrong. It doesn't matter. We're just making guesses because we want to learn. A good scientist takes measurements because you want to make sure you're putting in the right ingredients and the right amount of ingredients. So we want to make sure we're taking good measurements. A good scientist is safe and asks for help. So if you are doing these science experiments with us and you need a little bit of help or you need me to slow down because I know I talk really fast, then, you know, just let us know. Hi, Lydia! I'm so glad you're here. You're going to be doing science with me. I'm super excited. A good scientist wonders about the world. So a good scientist wants to learn everything that's out there. You want to know why the sky is blue. You want to know why your toenails keep growing even when you cut them off. You want to know why you have to use chemicals to change the color of your hair. Everything that you could potentially have a question about is a wonder of the world. So don't stop wondering. A good scientist makes predictions. So we're going to be doing our experiments and you'll have a chance to make a prediction about what's going to happen. So, make sure that you are taking time to make a prediction. You can throw it into our comments before we start the experiment if you want to make a prediction. And a good scientist uses their five senses. Our five senses are our sense of sight, our sense of smell, our sense of taste, our hearing, and our ability to touch things. Those are our five senses. We want to make sure we're using them all the time, except if it's something that's not supposed to be put in your mouth, then please do not put it in your mouth. I will let you know if something is safe to put in your mouth. But overall, we should probably just go with the rule of, like, don't put it in your mouth unless Miss Tammy says it's okay or your parents say it's okay. And most important, a good scientist never gives up. So never give up. No matter if you're wrong, no matter if you make a mistake, if you make a mess, never give up, because a good scientist never gives up. So we are going to be talking about the weather. Weather is something that you experience every single day, as long as you're going outside. I mean, you could probably be inside and just, like, not really take into account what's going on outside, but the weather is something you just can't avoid. Weather is what tells us what the atmosphere is like. Atmosphere, which, you know, is a really big word, so I get why that might be confusing. But atmosphere is all of the sky and the air that's around us. So I want you to take a second. I want you to breathe in the atmosphere. You ready? Breathe in the atmosphere. I'm breathing in the atmosphere. Breathe in the atmosphere with me. Just the atmosphere is all that air in your room, all the air outside. That is your atmosphere. And that is what changes with the weather. So, the types of weather we have, there are lots and lots of types of weather, but our big ones are sunny, which is what it is outside today. We have cloudy, which is what it was this morning. That fooled me into thinking that I needed a sweater, and I didn't. I was upset. You have windy weather, which is when the air is just like, and just kind of blows everything around. It gets a little like, your hair is just like, ah! Types of weather we still have. We have rainy weather, which is when, you know, you have to have an umbrella outside. I, myself, enjoy rainy weather. And we have snowy weather, which we don't get a lot of here in San Diego. But if you, like, drive up further north, or if you've lived somewhere that is really cold, then you get snow. We also have stormy weather, so that's your thunders, your lightnings. You have tornadoes, which we don't really get here, so don't worry about it. And then you also have just whether or not it's hot outside or it's cold outside. Does anyone have a favorite type of weather? Because I know, like I said, I love when it rains. I just enjoy being in rainy weather. Miss Lisa, do you have a favorite type of weather from our types of weather?
I like it to either be rainy or cloudy.
Ooh.
Because I get sunburned real easily, so I like no sun. So I'm okay with rainy or cloudy, you know.
I love it. I mean, I'm just all about the rain. I just like to get out there and splash in puddles and all that stuff. So I love rainy weather. At any point during this, you can feel free to jump into the comments and tell us about your favorite type of weather. But, you know, no pressure. So you've probably heard this word used before if you watch the news with your parents or you have the news in the background because you're doing stuff and your parents are trying to multitask. So you'll hear the word meteorologist. Now that is a specific type of scientist who predicts the weather, and they predict the weather by using tools and they study the weather patterns. So they look at how the weather was this time last year and how was the weather this time 10 years ago. And they look at those changes and those patterns in the weather to decide if it's going to be sunny tomorrow or cloudy tomorrow. And then they go on the news and they're like, our forecast for tomorrow is sunny. And then sometimes it's true and sometimes it's not. You know, it's all out of our hands. It's all about the atmosphere.
Whether you like it or not.
Whether you like it or not. I think the more fun part about this, though, is that we are going to be doing a experiment to show what it looks like when it rains and how rain is created. So for this portion of our STEM lesson, I'm going to need you to get around a table. You want somewhere that is flat. Of course, if you do not have all the supplies that you need for this experiment, you can just watch. I will be very descriptive. So it's just like you're here. So you're going to need a clear container, whether it be a vase or a bin. I feel like the bin is like for a lot more, I guess. And then this is for like a tiny one. I think we're gonna do like a tiny version, and then we're also gonna do like a giant version. Because, you know, you can have light rainfall or you can have really heavy rainfall. You're also going to need some water. I have a giant thing of water. It's just so much water. You'll need some shaving cream. This is not to be confused with whipped cream. It's not whipped cream. It should not go anywhere near your mouth. It is shaving cream, not whipped cream. I'm confusing myself. Where's where we at, man? This is why adults need to be around. We have food coloring. Mine is food coloring from a slime kit, but just in general, you just need food coloring. If you want to get really special with it, you could throw some glitter in there, you know? I like sparkly rain. And then I have these little tea droppers, or what, I don't know what kind of droppers they are. They're not tea droppers. What are they, Elisa?
I thought they were teardrops.
Are they teardrops? No, they're an eye dropper. We were all in the same area,
yeah.
Just like right here in the eyes. But it is a eyedropper. So you're gonna need a few of those. And then I have these cups of water to make my rain. So we're gonna start by first making our rain. So to make our rain, I'm gonna need my cups of water here, and we're gonna make different types of rain. So I want my rain, I think, to be rainbow. So take this time to grab your food coloring, and you're going to be putting in the colors to make the rain that you want. Now, while we're doing this, we're also going to talk about how rain is created. So just all over the world, there are different times where water is coming from the sky, whether it be snow, whether it's just regular rain. Sometimes it's runoff from rivers that all make their way down to the ocean. Oh, look, I have blue. That make their way down to the ocean. And then once it's in the ocean, the sun just heats up the ocean. You ever been outside and it's just like really hot and you're instantly sweaty and you're just like, ugh, it's too hot. I don't want to be outside. And then you go inside and you turn on the AC or you like sit in front of the fan, maybe have some ice cream or something. So when it's really hot, the sun hits the water in the ocean and makes it evaporate. What that is when the water just kind of starts to turn into vapor and it goes straight up into the sky into the big clouds up there. I'm making this water blue. Sorry, I'm going to be like throwing myself all over the place here. So the vapors go all the way up to the clouds and the clouds hold on to that vapor and it just keeps holding it like a sponge. And then once it's just so full, once the cloud is so heavy, it can't hold all the water, it then just lets all the water out, and that's your rain. If it's really cold where you are, then you get snow, because the rain freezes on its way down to the ground, and then you get snow. So that is, I mean, it's essentially the water cycle. The water just moves its way through. It comes down, it goes back into the ocean, it gets heated up and moves back up into the clouds, and then it gets dropped down like rain. It's great. I love it so much. And that's why it's my favorite also, because, you know, who doesn't love jumping in puddles? You know what I mean? Ah!
Whoa.
This one's not open.
What?
It's really hard to be just like a mad scientist when things are not open. And it just kind of takes away from the magic of what we're doing. We have some green. We have green already. Purple? Tan? No. Who wants tan rain? I don't want tan rain. Does anybody have any questions? Is anyone doing this experiment with me? I love when people do stuff with me. It's really exciting. It makes me feel like you're like right here with me, but just like not in the same place at the same time. Woo! I put a lot of purple in that. This is gonna be the purpliest of all purples. And let's do some red. Red! So I'm gonna be making rainbow rain to show you how the water cycle works when it comes to clouds and rain. So I have all of my water thingies here and they all have different colors. We've got red, which you can't really see. Woo! There it is. Got some red in there. And I'm going to get another dropper. We've got, what color do we think this is? Do we know? Is anyone paying attention?
Blue.
Purple. Woo! I'm excited. This is really fun. It's like a guessing game. Okay, Miss Lisa, I hope you're paying attention.
I wasn't.
What's the next color?
Blue.
It's yellow! Kind of looks like pee. It's okay. Okay, next color. We got this.
That one purple. Blue.
What is it?
Blue, right?
What color is it?
Green.
It's
blue.
Ah. Don't doubt yourself, man. Making guesses makes you a good scientist. Okie dokie, here we go. What's the next one?
Red.
Red?
Yes.
Okay, is it red?
Wait, no,
ah,
green.
It's green. No, you did not say it.
So we already said red.
You were like, she did it twice.
She did it twice.
Okay, last one. Orange. Are you ready?
Orange.
Is it orange? It's pink. Like pink lemonade. I love it so much. Okay, so we have all these colors here. I'm excited. Now, the next step is to create our rain cloud in our atmosphere. So I'm going to put water in my clear vase here, and that's going to be kind of like our sky, which is really funny, I think, because our sky isn't actually made of water, but for this experiment it is. So here is our water, and we're going to get our shaving cream. Here we go. To make our clouds. So this shaving cream is going to basically be our clouds. Ah! It's a fluffy cloud. Woo! It's like, you know, it's like seeing the Who's down in Whoville. Okay, it smells great, by the way. Just throwing that out there. So, this is our water, which is pretending to be our atmosphere, like we talked about earlier. So, this water is basically our atmosphere, which is the air that we breathe. Take a second, breathe in air. Super fun. Just great. Okay, this is our atmosphere, and this shaving cream is going to be our cloud. So we need to fill our cloud with enough water vapor to create rain. So we're going to take our droppers in all of our different colors, and we're going to be dropping water into our cloud. Okay, so I have all these rainbow colors, and I want my cloud to be very colorful. So I'm going to be using a bunch of different colors, actually. I might do different colors for our big one. For this one, I might just use two colors. What two colors should we use? Miss Elisa.
Purple.
Purple. And?
Pink.
Purple and pink. Okay. So we are going to pretend that we are the masters of nature. And we are going to keep putting drops of water and water vapor into our cloud until it breaks through and makes the cloud so heavy with water that it breaks into our atmosphere and produces rain. Oh, I see some going through. Let me know when you see colors, because that means that our water vapor has taken over and broken through our cloud. Ooh, and has started to produce rain. So we're still evaporating the water from the sea and turning it into water vapor. See any? Does anybody see any? I see some on this side. It's really hard for you guys to see, I think. But it's getting ready to rain. I can see it right now. It's beautiful. It's getting ready to rain. This again is showing our rain when the water vapor gets heated up by the sun out of the ocean and makes its way up into the clouds, and the clouds get super full of water, and then they start producing rain. Oh my goodness. Oh, there it goes. We're finally getting through. I see it. There's like a whole layer. I'm shaking it a little bit so you can see it. I see some purple. Oh, it's dropping. There it goes. Let's see if we can just kind of get some more in there. It's beautiful. I love it so much. It's just so gorgeous. Oh,
whoa.
There we go. So our clouds are getting super full of rain. Well, of water vapor, which then produces rain, which I love so much. This is great. I love it. Now I would like to do a bigger one. So this is our, let me see if I can mix it a little bit so you guys can see it. Ooh. Yeah, it's a mess. Here it is. Oh, there we go. It's dropping now and it's turning all of our water purple and pink. So this is rain. That's what you're seeing here. The purple that's coming through is all of our water vapor that got evaporated from the ocean, put into our clouds, and the clouds got so heavy and so full of water that they dropped it back down to the earth as rain or as snow if it's really, really cold where you are. So now we're gonna do our giant version of this in our giant container. I love it, I'm so excited. I love doing like really in-depth experiments with a lot of like touching and stuff. So I think for this one, I might actually touch our rain clouds. So we're gonna put in a bunch of water. Ooh, super exciting. And we're gonna need a bunch of shaving cream because we have so much water. So here we go. Ah, this is actually a really fun part, I think, of just like getting into everything. What do you think, Miss Elisa? I feel like it smells really good in here.
It smells really good.
Here we go. Here we go.
Well,
I think this is like the most fun thing that I get to do today is hang out with you guys and spray shaving cream. Okay. So this is kind of what you see in the sky right now, which is just like a bunch of clouds. So imagine this is our entire sky, right? It's got all of its clouds. We have the water, which is showing our atmosphere. I kind of wish I had like some sort of, you know, like a
screen.
Kind of like a screen.
Or
a screen. Sorry. I wish I would had it up to my eyes because I was really intrigued. So all of that clear area right there is going to be our atmosphere or our air. And then our shaving cream is our clouds. So now we're going to be trying to put as many colors as we can into this so that we can have rainbow rain. So I've got some blue here and some pink here. And Miss Lisa, you're more than welcome to shoot some other colors in here if you would like. I've got some purples. It's just rainbow, man. And some greens. We've got some red in here. Do we see any of the other colors coming through yet? I don't think so.
Just a few.
There's some. Just put it somewhere in there. So these are all of our colors being pushed in and evaporated out of the water and the ocean to make our rain clouds. I love it. It's just so colorful. And afterwards, you can definitely put your hands just all inside of it and like play with it a little bit. It's a very clean way to make a mess. It's a very clean way to make a mess.
I mean, you're not wrong.
I don't know. It's very pastel coloring right now. It looks very like Easter, you know? Oh, and some of our colors are starting to bleed through.
The blue back there is bleeding through.
There we go. See? The colors that are coming through, that means that that section of the clouds has the most water vapor in it. And so it's starting to just kind of push the rain through so that it rains on Earth. So continue to put more of your water with food coloring through to get all of your rain in there. I'm trying to create just all the rain, just like so many different colors. Woo! I want it to be a rainbow pile of amazingness forever and ever. Is anybody else doing one of these? Anybody else on here hanging out with us, making messes? I mean, I'm excited. I'm always excited to make a mess. Not super excited to clean up afterwards, but I know it's necessary. So I go along with it, I guess. Do you have any questions about weather? I mean, I did a lot of research. So, you know, I've got a lot of answers for a lot of questions. But not a lot of questions because I've already done a lot of research. I don't know if that made any sense. That's where we're at, guys. So, if you have any questions and you want to ask, feel free to ask in the comments and let us know. Ooh, these are looking really cool.
That's cool. That's really cool.
I think it's really interesting that, like, not all the colors are heavy enough yet to push through. We've got a lot of yellow, which is really interesting, and a lot of reds and some purples. And I don't know if you guys can see this. I'm going to try and bring it closer, but, like, our clouds are just a bunch of, like, different colors here, which is really funny. It's got, like, very, I want to say pastel. Very pasteling colors here. And just for your enjoyment, because I love getting messy, I'm going to stick my hand in this and really just get in there. I'm going to mix some colors. Ooh.
Oh.
I love it. I love putting my hands in these things and, like, really mixing these colors up. Because I've always wondered if clouds, like, actually felt fluffy because they look really fluffy. But they don't. They're not, like, fluffy per se. They're just vapor. It's just a lot of air. It's not something you could actually, like, touch. And there are some experiments you can do to, like, recreate what clouds look like. We just don't have liquid nitrogen on hand to do that.
Have you ever touched a cloud,
Miss? I've never touched an actual cloud, but I have touched, like, a recreation of a cloud.
Mm-hmm.
Which is like when you put water into liquid nitrogen, it produces a cloud because it instantly freezes the water to create those vapors that create clouds.
Mm-hmm. What about hail? So how will hail sit? Do you know?
So hail is just bigger clumps of water vapor put together. So it's not as delicate as snow. Snow is like the tiniest little vapors turning into like freezing and then coming down to earth. And there's snow. But hail is a lot harder because it's a heavier amount or mass of water. And then it comes down like little stones out of the sky. But it is just frozen water.
Got it.
Ooh, can we color my hands? My hands are super,
what color?
Super white. I don't know. Let's just get all in there. If you have any questions, feel free. If you're doing this along with us, I would love to see pictures. I love seeing how you guys do these because you might do them completely different than I do them, which is great. Everybody's entitled to doing their stuff their own way. Oh, look at it. Blah, 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 blah. I love it. It's just so nice and it's soft. It's what I would imagine clouds feel like. I wish I could feel clouds. Does anybody else wish they could feel clouds? I wish I could feel clouds.
I would love to feel clouds.
Snow!
I'm sure this is why I'm saying San Diego snow.
I'm so glad that you like snow. I wish it snowed here in San Diego. I think it would be so much more exciting if it snowed in San Diego, but I also don't think any of us are prepared to deal with snow because it's not something that's common down here. So if we did have snow, no one would know what to do except to stay inside and try to keep warm because we're used to wearing flip-flops in the winter.
Yep, and shorts.
Thank you so much for writing in. I'm just over here getting my hands all messy and playing with colors and talking about weather.
Whether or not you like it.
Whether you like it or not. Oh my goodness. So, if anybody has any questions, of course, feel free, even after this is over, feel free to leave a comment and one of us will get back to you with an answer to your question. And even if you're watching this later, you're not watching it live, and you're watching just a rerun of it, that's what it's called. Is it called a rerun?
Yeah.
If you're watching a rerun of this show, still feel free to put your questions in, and we will make sure to come back and answer them for you. I hope that you will be back with us next week when I do for my class. And hi, Logan! I'm so excited that you're here! Logan was here for camp.
Aww.
So, we will be doing this every Tuesday, and it'll always be
Wednesday.
I don't know what day it is. We'll be doing this every Wednesday. It'll always be at 2:30, and we'll be doing different topics so that you can learn more and more about the world around us. Also, if you have older siblings or if you just want to do science twice in a week, we also do this on Fridays for our older kids, third grade and above. And they will be doing, what's the topic this Friday, Miss Elisa?
It's about the weather cycle. So how rain is collected and brought back to the ground. Kind of like what you're doing today, but we get a little bit more deeper into it for the older kids.
There you go. So you can always hang out with Miss Tammy on Wednesdays at 2:30 for our kinder to second grade science experiments and science classes online, or you can come back on Fridays and be here for our third grade and above science and STEM classes online with Miss Elisa.
Hi.
So, of course, if you have any questions, if you want to send us pictures of you doing these science experiments, or if you have any questions about things that you want to know more about, or if you have an idea about a science experiment that you would like to see us do, go ahead and throw it in the comments. We would love to try them. We will be seeing you this Friday or next week on Wednesday when I'm back here again with another science experiment.